It's a state that is still battered by the worst bout of floods in a century.
കനത്ത മഴയിലും മലവെള്ളപ്പാച്ചിലും ഇടുക്കി ജില്ലയിൽ വ്യാപക ഉരുൾപൊട്ടലും കൃഷിനാശവും മലവെള്ളപ്പാച്ചിലിൽ പള്ളിവാസികൾ
Dramatic visuals coming in from Kerala.
മഴക്കെടുതിയിൽ ഇന്ന് മാത്രം 24 മരണം. മലപ്പുറം പെരിങ്ങാവിൽ വീടിന് മുകളിലേക്ക് മണ്ണിടിഞ്ഞ് വീണ് ഒരു കുടുംബത്തിലെ 8 പേർ മരിച്ചു.
9 people were killed here. There was one family, some relatives and some neighbors as well.
Southern India's Kerala state was hit by the worst flooding it's seen in a century.
Through what officials say are the worst floods for a century.
After 36 years, it's the first time that such flooding is happening here.
സംസ്ഥാനത്ത് തുടരുന്ന കനത്ത മഴയിൽ വ്യാപക നാശനഷ്ടം.
200,000 people, that's a figure that we have so far as per the reports, and it's going up.
Hundreds of troops and dozens of boats and helicopters are helping to evacuate
people. Kerala woke up to a catastrophe of a lifetime when the unusually high rainfall and landslides claimed the lives of more than 400 people in August 2018. The state estimated a loss of more than 20,000 crores and is believed to take years for its recovery. While the Kerala government is spearheading the rebuilding and rehabilitation process, there are many partially affected families who failed to make the cut to receive government support. Kerala Realtors Association aspires to be a ray of hope for those families who have not received the support they deserve. The National Association of Realtors India's Flood Relief Fund is facilitated through Kerala Realtors Association. We have shortlisted 15 applicants from the pool of 55 who need immediate support. The Honorable Secretary of National Association of Realtors India has handed over 1 lakh rupees check as an advance from the Flood Relief Fund towards the rebuilding activities of the affected. While we strive to do our best, we could multiply the impact with your support. If you wish to ensure that the lives we have saved are not left astray, join us in the mission and contribute at While it's easy to aspire change, it's people like you who come forward and act that makes the difference.
First of all, I thank NAR India and the convention committee who has given us an opportunity to present about what has happened 2 months before. We were all in the safe zone, but unfortunately, due to a heavy rainfall, natural calamities, it's not in our control. This was after 39 years, this is the second experience we are facing. And the major cause was basically about the overflood of about like 33 dams, which we have about 39 dams. Out of that, 33 dams were being overflowed. So the shutters has to be raised, and that has led to a big, massive, and damages. Thousands of houses were washed off on landslides. You are aware about the places like Monar, you know, Coorg, and like Wayanad. These were the places where had a massive landslides. Over more than 10 lakh people were in the relief camps. And one thing what we have seen is that across the world, we had helps, supports coming to serve the people. 14 out of 16 districts were in the red alert, and the airports were being closed, and the airport, one full floor has been completely was sink. So this was a magic. This was a big tragedy for us. And 14th of August, I appealed before NAR India President and Secretary and the board meeting. And I told them that NAR India also should have a presence in the flood relief activities like the other organization does. So immediately the President Praveen Fancy has approved it and asked all the associations to take an initiative support for the relief activities. Now, what we are doing here is basically about, there are a lot of organizations going and supporting in different locations of neighboring parts of Cochin. We Cochin people are safe, but 30 kilometers towards all the sides of Cochin was being affected. And, you know, towards the southern side of Cochin, we have taken a village named as Thalaiolaparamb. So where the basic criteria, what we have seen is that government's support is being given to all the people who have been affected, who has affected 100%, means who has lost their house or properties. So this is their priority. But here, the issue is that the people who are in the relief camp, who have been partially damaged, or who have been partially affected, if they need to come back to their home, the issue is that they need some sort of a rebuilding activities need to be done. And these people are below poverty level of the country. And we personally visited these locations, and we could see that what we have seen is that the main income source of the family in these areas would be either the person would be disabled, permanently disabled, or he might be, you know, he might be dead, or some sort of disabilities are there. So such houses, we have taken, there are two wards of the village, and out of the two panchayats, with the authorities, we have taken the two panchayats, and we have shortlisted 15 houses out of 55 houses. And we got our secretary on a day, and we had handed over the first advance checks to our members, to the workers, and we started rebuilding the homes. Currently, we have rebuilt five houses. We have taken about five houses, and it has been on the final verge. And what I plead before you all is that please discuss with your members, please discuss with your in your association, and see that NAR India should have a name in the relief activities as the CREDAI, or like, you know, as the other organization does. We also should have a name, and I request everybody's support in this. And I humbly request before you, and we have our members also here, thank you for giving this once again this opportunity. Thank you.